Hey everyone, and welcome back to another video that's loosely connected to my name. Icebergs. You know them, I know them, the 2,240 passengers of the Titanic definitely know them. After watching far too many of these videos in my free time, I thought I should make one of my own. So, since I like Star Wars and the word character is in my name, I decided to explain the Star Wars character iceberg I found. Now, before we start, I feel like I'm obligated to explain how this works. Well-known characters are at the top, and the characters get increasingly more obscure as you descend. And I will try my best to explain each character thoroughly. Oh, and this iceberg is pretty big, so I expect this video to be pretty long. So sit back and relax as I play some video game music while explaining the many, many characters of the Star Wars universe. And without further ado, let's get started. So you guys probably know most, if not all, of these guys, so I'll try to get through them pretty fast. Luke. Luke Skywalker is the son of Anakin Skywalker and the person responsible for defeating Darth Vader and saving the galaxy from the Empire. He was a Jedi Master and, depending on the continuity, died on a rock. Leia. Former Princess Leia Organa / Skywalker / Solo is both Anakin Skywalker's daughter and Luke Skywalker's sister. Leia was raised on Alderaan by her adoptive parents, Bail and Brea Organa. She eventually became a military leader and died after she got too tired. Probably should have mentioned before that I'm not a fan of the sequels. Han Solo. Han Solo was a smuggler and eventual rebel leader who aided them in their fight against the Empire. He eventually got with Leia and they had a son who then killed him. Anakin / Darth Vader. Probably the most famous Star Wars character. Anakin Skywalker was a slave child who eventually grew up to become one of the most powerful Jedi of all time. He was manipulated by Darth Sidious into turning on his fellow Jedi and, after a fight with his master Obi-Wan, became the Sith Lord known as Darth Vader. However, he was able to come back to the light side after his son Luke helped him see that there was still good in him. Obi-Wan. Obi-Wan Kenobi was a Jedi Master and member of the Jedi Council who trained Anakin Skywalker and eventually Luke Skywalker. After giving Luke some basic training, he was cut down by his former student Darth Vader. However, he lived on as a Force ghost and further helped Luke along his Jedi journey. Darth Sidious. Chief Palpatine,
or should I call you Darth Sidious,
was a Dark Lord of the Sith and Chancellor during the Republic era. After converting Anakin Skywalker to the dark side, he reorganized the Republic into the
Galactic Empire!
He was eventually killed by Anakin, except he wasn't, because
somehow Palpatine returned.
He was then quickly killed by Rey. Rey. Rey Palpatine is a Jedi who grew up on Jakku and is the granddaughter of Sheev Palpatine. She trained under Luke and Leia and aided the resistance against the First Order. As stated previously, she defeated Palpatine after he returned. Lando. Lando Calrissian is a smuggler turned rebel turned resistance member. He was the original owner of Han's Millennium Falcon and the leader of Cloud City on Bespin during the Imperial era. R2-D2. R2-D2 is an astromech droid who has been pretty much everywhere. He was under the service of Padme and Anakin during the Republic era and then given to Bail Organa. He eventually found his way in the service of Luke Skywalker and followed him on most of his adventures. And after the Empire fell, R2 found himself in the possession of the Resistance. C-3PO. C-3PO is a protocol droid and friend of R2-D2. Like his friend, he was present for most of the main film's events. He was built by Anakin Skywalker and supported both the Rebellion and the Resistance. BB-8. BB-8 is an astromech droid who belonged to Poe Dameron. He was present for most of the events of the sequel trilogy and aided the Resistance in their fight against the First Order. Finn. FN-2187, now known as Finn, was a former stormtrooper. He eventually joined the Resistance, and it is a crime that he never became a Jedi. Ahsoka. Ahsoka Tano is a Togruta Jedi who trained under Anakin Skywalker during the Clone Wars. She eventually left the Jedi Order and years later aided the Rebellion against the Empire. Darth Maul. Darth Maul was a Dathomirian Sith Lord who served under Palpatine. During a fight with Obi-Wan, he lost his legs and stopped being Palpatine's apprentice. He would end up dying in another fight with Obi-Wan decades later. Dooku. Count Dooku, or Darth Tyranus, was a Sith Lord and politician during the Republic era. He served under Palpatine and ended up being killed by Anakin near the end of the Clone Wars. Poe Dameron. Poe Dameron is a New Republic and eventual Resistance pilot who was active for pretty much the entire events of the sequel trilogy. Yoda. Yoda was a Jedi Grandmaster of an unknown species who was on the Jedi Council during the Age of the Republic and trained Luke Skywalker during the Age of the Empire. He would end up dying of natural causes at the ripe old age of 900. Grogu. Grogu is a Force-sensitive child and member of Yoda's species. He is a survivor of Order 66 and under the care of Mandalorian Din Djarin. Din Djarin. Din Djarin is a Mandalorian who lost his parents near the end of the Republic era. He is mostly active post-Empire and is the protector of Grogu. As of now, he technically isn't a Mandalorian since he revealed his face to other people, but this might change in Season 3. Cara Dune. Cara Dune is a former shock trooper and current friend of Din Djarin. She aided him in his quest to rescue Grogu. Boba Fett. Boba Fett is a former bounty hunter and current crime lord of Tatooine. He is a clone of bounty hunter Jango Fett and aided the Galactic Empire numerous times. After falling into and escaping a Sarlacc pit, he ended up taking over Jabba the Hutt's crime empire from Bib Fortuna. Jabba. Jabba Desilijictur, or Jabba the Hutt, was a Tatooine crime lord who was active during both the Republic and Empire eras. He would end up being killed by Leia Organa after trying to execute Han Solo and Luke Skywalker. Mace Windu. Mace Windu was a Jedi Master who was active during the Age of the Republic. He was very active during the Clone Wars and was eventually killed by Anakin Skywalker after a fight with Palpatine. Jar Jar Binks. Jar Jar Binks is a Gungan warrior, politician, and potential Sith Lord who mainly was active during the Republic era. He is the one responsible for giving Palpatine emergency powers, which he used to transform the Republic into the Empire. Grievous. General Grievous, formerly known as Kaiman Jai Shalal, was a separatist general of the droid army. His death at the hands of Obi-Wan was what ended the Clone Wars. Shmi. Shmi Skywalker / Lars is the mother of Anakin Skywalker. She was also a slave on Tatooine and ended up marrying a man who freed her from that slavery. She was killed by Tusken Raider shortly after, though. Qui-Gon Jinn. Qui-Gon Jinn is a Jedi Master with a particular set of skills. Skills he has acquired over a very long career. Skills that make him a nightmare for people like you. Mark his words, he will find you, and he will kill you. Jyn Erso. Jyn Erso was a soldier and former criminal who ended up aiding the rebellion in their efforts to acquire the schematics of the Death Star. While being successful, this mission ultimately ended with her death. Jango Fett. Jango Fett was a bounty hunter and is the DNA source for both Boba Fett and the entire clone army. He had a prolific career during the Republic era before being killed by Mace Windu at the start of the Clone Wars. Kylo Ren. Kylo Ren, aka Ben Solo, is technically not a Sith, but is a powerful user of the dark side. He was a member and eventually supreme leader of the First Order. He ended up sacrificing himself for Rey after their final fight against Palpatine. Chewbacca. Chewbacca, or Chewie, is a Wookiee and longtime friend of Han Solo. He has aided the Republic, Rebellion, and Resistance in each of their wars. Phasma. Captain Phasma was a stormtrooper captain of the First Order. She was killed by Finn and Rose Tico during a fight on the Supremacy ship. Snoke. Snoke is a Force-sensitive clone created by Palpatine to act as a puppet. He ended up being killed by Kylo Ren. General Hux. General Armitage Hux was a First Order general who ended up betraying them by supplying the Resistance with info. However, his double-crossing was discovered and he was quickly killed. Rose. Rose Tico was a Resistance maintenance worker and eventual leader of the Resistance Engineering Corps. That's pretty much it. Okay, finally made it to the next tier. Most of these guys are still pretty well known to most basic Star Wars fans, so I'll also try to move through these guys quickly. Tarkin. Grand Moff Wilhuff Tarkin was a politician and military leader for the Empire who ended up dying when the first Death Star blew up. Thrawn. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce that. Thrawn was a military leader of the Empire, and after the fall of the Empire, he disappeared. His current whereabouts are unknown, but is probably gonna show up in the Ahsoka show. Darth Plagueis.
Darth Plagueis was a dark lord of the Sith, so powerful and so wise. He could use the Force to influence the midichlorians to create life. He had such a knowledge of the dark side, he could even keep the ones he cared about from dying. He became so powerful. The only thing he was afraid of was losing his power, which eventually, of course, he did. Unfortunately, he taught his apprentice everything he knew. Then his apprentice killed him in his sleep.
Ezra. Ezra Bridger was a Jedi Padawan who aided in the rebellion of the Empire. Gotta be honest, I still have to watch Rebels. Bo-Katan. Bo-Katan Kryze is a Mandalorian who has been active since the Age of the Republic. She was last seen refusing to accept the Darksaber from Din Djarin and is supposed to show up in Mandalorian Season 3. Sabine Wren. Sabine Wren was a Mandalorian and rebel leader during the Imperial era. Still gotta watch Rebels. Cal Kestis. Cal Kestis is a Jedi Knight and one of the few who survived Order 66. He's also the protagonist of my favorite Star Wars game, Hunter. Hunter was a clone commando sergeant and commanding officer of Clone Force 99, aka the Bad Batch, during the Clone Wars. Omega. Omega was a female clone of Jango Fett. She ended up leaving Kamino to accompany Clone Force 99. Echo. CT-1409, or Echo, was a clone trooper during the Republic era. After an explosion left him severely injured, he was fitted with multiple cyborg enhancements. He eventually ended up joining with Clone Force 99. Crosshair. CT-9905, or Crosshair, was a clone commando and member of Clone Force 99 who, after Order 66, decided to side with the Empire despite none of his comrades doing the same. Rex. CT-7567, or Rex, was a clone captain, commander, and advanced recon commando. Rex was able to remove his inhibitor chip thanks to Ahsoka, and he eventually joined and aided the rebellion. Tech and Wrecker. These two are both members of Clone Force 99. Their names pretty much sum up their roles on the team. Kit Fisto. Kit Fisto was an Atulian Jedi Master who served on the Jedi Council during the Republic era. He met his end during a duel with Palpatine. Asajj Ventress. Asajj Ventress was a Dathomirian, former Padawan, and Sith assassin. During the Clone Wars, she served under Count Dooku and became a military commander for the droid army. She ended up dying to Dooku after sacrificing herself to save Quinlan Vos. Bail Organa. Bail Organa was a Republic politician and the adoptive father of Leia Organa. He was on Alderaan when it blew up. Mon Mothma. Mon Mothma was a politician who, after the Empire took control, aided the rebellion in numerous ways. In main canon, she is still alive, however in Legends, she died peacefully 2 decades after the fall of the Empire. Deepa Balapa. Deepa Balapa was a Jedi on the High Council during the Republic era. She trained under Mace Windu and is one of the many Jedi to die in Order 66. Kanan Jarrus. Kanan Jarrus was a Jedi Knight who trained under Deepa Balapa during the Clone Wars. He survived Order 66 thanks to her sacrifice and ended up aiding in the rebellion. He died sacrificing himself to save his fellow rebels. Hera Syndulla. Hera Syndulla is a Twi'lek rebel leader and pilot who aided the rebellion in many battles, including the Battle of Jakku. Sifo Dyas. Sifo Dyas was a Jedi Master who was responsible for commissioning the creation of the clone troopers. He died after Count Dooku ordered assassins to shoot down his ship. Mara Jade. Mara Jade slash Skywalker is the wife of Luke Skywalker in Legends. She was a Jedi Master and during the Second Galactic Civil War, she was killed by her own nephew, Jason Solo. Ki-Adi Mundi. Ki-Adi Mundi is a Sarian Jedi Master and member of the Jedi Council during the Republic era. He was very active during the Clone Wars and met his end during Order 66. Wedge Antilles. Wedge Antilles was a Red Squadron starfighter pilot who flew alongside Luke Skywalker during the first Death Star attack. After that, he flew in many more battles for the Rebellion and eventually Resistance, including the Battle of Hoth, Jakku, and Exegol. Greedo. Greedo was a Rodian bounty hunter who was regularly employed by Jabba the Hutt. He met his end after a heated confrontation with a neck-snapping Han Solo. Aura Singh. Aura Singh was a Force-sensitive Paladuvan who left the Jedi Order to become a bounty hunter. She was mainly active during the Clone Wars and helped train Boba Fett after the death of his father. She died off-screen when a man working for the Crimson Dawn pushed her off a cliff. Zam Wessel. Zam Wessel is a shape-shifting bounty hunter who was ordered to assassinate Padme Amidala. However, her attempt failed and she was quickly killed by Jango Fett. Cassian Andor. Cassian Andor was a rebel spy, pilot, and assassin who ultimately sacrificed himself so that the rebellion could get a hold of the Death Star plans. He also has a pretty good Disney Plus show. You should check it out. Luminara Unduli. Luminara Unduli was a Mirialan Jedi Master who participated in many Clone Wars battles. She was ultimately captured and executed by the Empire after the Battle of Kashyyyk. Barriss Offee. Barriss Offee was a Mirialan Jedi Knight who trained under Luminara Unduli. She was ultimately corrupted by the dark side and bombed the Jedi Temple before being arrested. Her fate is currently unknown. Ayla Secura. Ayla Secura was a Twi'lek Jedi Master who served as a general during the Clone Wars. She was one of the many Jedi that perished during Order 66. Willrow Hood. Willrow Hood is an extra in The Empire Strikes Back that can be seen running in the background for 2 seconds. The thing he's holding is a cantono, which is something that is used to hold other things, typically money. I actually made a video on this guy half a year ago. It's not that good, but it's there if you want to see it. DJ. DJ, which is short for Don't Join, was a slicer that operated during the First Order Resistance War. By the way, if you don't know, a slicer is basically just a Star Wars word for hacker. Anyway, he's best known for helping Rose and Finn get on board the First Order ship, the Supremacy, before betraying them to save his own life. Holdo. Amalyn Holdo was a politician and military commander during the First Order Resistance War. Her life ended when she sacrificed herself in order to ensure the escape of the Resistance from the First Order. Ackbar. Admiral Gael Akbar was a Mon Calamari soldier and leader during the Clone Wars, Galactic Civil War, and First Order Resistance War. He met his fate when two First Order TIE fighters launched torpedoes at the ship he was on. Krennic. Orson Callan Krennic was the director of the Imperial Military Department of Advanced Weapons Research. He used to be the commander of the first Death Star and died after its laser was used on Scarif. Maz Kanata. Maz Kanata is the owner of an ancient castle on Takodana. She uses it as a home for traveling smugglers. She is apparently older than Yoda and also of an unknown species. She also frequently supports the Resistance. Lor San Tekka. Lor San Tekka was a parishioner of the Church of the Force despite not being Force sensitive. He helped Luke Skywalker find ancient Jedi texts after the fall of the Empire, however he was ultimately killed by Kylo Ren after refusing to give up the location of the map to Luke. Dryden Vos. Dryden Vos was the public face for the Crimson Dawn crime syndicate during the Imperial era, though after getting into a fight with Han Solo, he was betrayed and killed by his assistant Kira. Okay, here we go. Now we're going to get into some slightly more obscure guys. Nothing too crazy just yet, but we're out of the very obvious section. Galen Merrick. Galen Merrick, aka Starkiller, was Darth Vader's secret apprentice in Legends and my favorite Star Wars character. He was trained to be a master of the dark side ever since he was a child, however he ended up turning to the light side, though he did continue to use dark side power, so I guess technically he's a gray Jedi. Anyway, he died sacrificing himself to save his friends and rebel leaders from being killed by Palpatine. Raven. Raven was an ancient Sith Lord. That's all we know about him in canon. However, in Legends, Raven was a Jedi turned Sith turned Jedi again during the Republic's war with the Mandalorians. His death is complicated to say the least, but from what I can understand, he died like twice but continued to live because he was too angry to die and only later became one with the Force. Shaak-Ti. Shaak-Ti was a Togruta Jedi Master who served on the Jedi High Council during the Republic Age. She fought in many battles during the Clone Wars and was killed by Anakin Skywalker during Order 66. Fun fact, in Legends, she survived Order 66, but was killed by Starkiller years later. Plo Koon. Plo Koon was a Kel Dor Jedi Master who served on the Jedi High Council during the Republic Age. He also happens to be my favorite background Jedi just because he looks cool. He ended up dying during Order 66 when his clones shot him out of the sky. Quinlan Vos. Quinlan Vos was a Kefar Jedi Master who flip-flopped between the dark and light side of the Force. However, he ultimately chose the light side and somehow survived Order 66. His current whereabouts are unknown, however we do know that he assisted fugitive Jedi and Force-sensitive people during the reign of the Empire. Cody. CC-2224, or Cody, was a clone marshal commander who commanded the 7th Sky Corps during the Clone Wars. During Order 66, he failed to kill Obi-Wan Kenobi and his current fate is unknown. He most likely just died of old age, though. Wat Tambor. Wat Tambor is the foreman of the Techno Union and the executive of the Bactoid Armor Workshop. During the Clone Wars, he sided with the Separatists and was killed alongside them by Darth Vader on Mustafar. Avar Kriss. Avar Kriss was a Jedi Master during the High Republic era. She was seen as noble and an inspiration to many of her fellow Jedi, though her fate is currently unknown. Darth Talon. Okay, I know it says Darth Talus, but I'm pretty sure that's a typo and the guy who made this means Darth Talon. Anyway, Darth Talon was a Red Twi'lek who trained under Darth Roon and eventually Darth Krayt. She was part of the One Sith, a secret order made up of powerful dark side users. Her fate is unknown, however she probably died a year or two after joining the One Sith thanks to Darth Red's insurgency destroying all of the Sith. Dengar. Dengar the Demolisher was a bounty hunter who has been operating since the Clone Wars. He was one of the many bounty hunters to go after Han Solo in Empire Strikes Back. After the fall of the Empire, Dengar went under heavy cybernetic surgery to enhance his own capabilities. Some people now suspect that he is the bounty hunter Rothgar Deng. If true, that means he was probably killed on Kijimi since he was there around the same time the resurrected Emperor destroyed that planet. Bosk. Bosk Wasak Kradosk is a Trandoshan bounty hunter who has been operating since the Clone Wars. Bosk was also one of the bounty hunters hired by Vader to capture Solo. His current whereabouts are unknown, however he may or may not have died when Jabba's barge blew up. Sais Tin. Sais Tin was a Jedi Master who served on the High Council during the final years of the Republic. He was one of the Jedi killed by Palpatine when Mace and them tried to arrest him. Maz Ameda. Maz Ameda was a Chagrian politician and Grand Vizier of the Galactic Empire. He is the one responsible for convincing Jar Jar Binks to giving Palpatine emergency powers. He was also one of the most respected figures in the Empire, however after the Battle of Jakku, he surrendered to the New Republic and was placed on Coruscant as a powerless nominal leader. Adi Gallia. Adi Gallia was a Jedi Master and High Council member who was prominently active during the Clone Wars. She was ultimately killed by Darth Maul's brother, Savage Opress. Cad Bane. Cad Bane was a Duros bounty hunter who operated since the Republic era. He was very active during the Clone Wars, however met his end 5 years after the fall of the Empire during a confrontation with Boba Fett, Bib Fortuna. Bib Fortuna was a Twi'lek who ran the day-to-day operations at Jabba the Hutt's palace. He acted as Jabba's right-hand man until Jabba's eventual death. Afterwards, he took control of Jabba's crime syndicate before being killed by Boba Fett. Eeth Koth. Eeth Koth was an Iridornian Zabrak Jedi Master who served on the High Council. Like most of his fellow Jedi, he served as a general during the Clone Wars. However, he would end up leaving the Council and proceeded to go have a wife and son. Though shortly after his son was born, he was found and killed by Darth Vader. Darth Bane. Darth Bane was a legendary Dark Lord of the Sith and the creator of the Rule of Two. It is unknown how Bane died, however it's rumored that it was his apprentice, Darth Zanna. Darth Zanna. Darth Zanna was a powerful Sith Lord and Darth Bane's apprentice. Not much is known about her in canon, but in Legends she would end up having her own apprentice, Darth Cognis. And if the Rule of Two is anything to go by, then he probably killed her at some point. Darth Malak. Darth Malak was a Dark Lord of the Sith during the Jedi Civil War. He was Darth Raven's apprentice, and was eventually cut down by Jedi Master Basila Shan, ending the war. Wooher. Wooher is the bartender of Chalmun Spaceport Cantina, the cantina that Luke and Obi-Wan go to in A New Hope. Fun fact, the reason he hates droids so much is because he lost his parents to battle droids during the Clone Wars. Kriya. Kriya, or Darth Trya, was a former Jedi Master who trained Raven when he was still a Jedi. Though when she turned to the dark side, she trained multiple Sith apprentices. Later on, however, she chose to be neither Jedi or Sith, but something in between. She would end up being killed by one of her apprentices, a Jedi exile named Mitra Surik. Kyle Katarn. Kyle Katarn was a former Imperial officer who defected to the Rebellion. In Legends, he is responsible for stealing the first Death Star plans. He also happened to be Force-sensitive, and after the Empire fell, became a Jedi and taught at Luke Skywalker's Jedi Academy. Abeloth. Abeloth, also known as the Bringer of Chaos, was an ancient Force-sensitive entity who lived over 100,000 years before the prequel era. She originally served the Ones, an ancient family of immortal Force gods, before being imprisoned by them for drinking from the Font of Power in order to become immortal. Over 100,000 years later, Han and Leia's son, Jason Solo, now Darth Cadus, accidentally caused Abeloth to escape. However, Luke Skywalker was able to hunt her down and destroy her for good. Tulak Horde. Tulak Horde, also known as the Lord of Hate, was a Dark Lord of the Sith that ruled during the early Sith Empire. Like many Sith, Tulak would end up being killed by his own apprentice, Orten Sella. Naga Sado. Naga Sado was an ancient Sith Lord who led the Sith Empire during the Great Hyperspace War. He was ultimately killed by his apprentice, Freedon Nadd. Marka Ragnos. Marka Ragnos was an ancient Dark Lord of the Sith who also lived during the Sith Empire era. He died shortly before the Great Hyperspace War, however was resurrected 1,000 years later by a Dark Jedi named Tavion Axmis. He was defeated pretty quickly after that, though. Vidiate. Darth Vidiate, or Tenebrae, was the Sith Empire post-Great Hyperspace War. He has died multiple times because he was able to transfer his soul through multiple bodies. He was ultimately defeated for good, however, by a Jedi named Satil Shan. Dirge. Dirge was a bounty hunter who was active during the Clone Wars and Imperial era. However, in Legends, he has been a bounty hunter for around 2,000 years. He ultimately met his end after a fight with young Anakin Skywalker where he force-pushed him into a star. Embo. Embo was a Kyuzo bounty hunter who was mainly active during the Clone Wars. He did a few jobs during the Imperial era, however after the Battle of Jakku, he retired and became a farmer. Aphra. Chelly Lona Aphra was an archaeologist who was hired by Darth Vader sometime after the Battle of Yavin. She did a few jobs for him before they had a falling out, which resulted in her having to fake her own death in order to escape him. After that, she just continued to roam the galaxy with her two droids. Yar-El Poof. Yar-El Poof was a Jedi Master who served on the High Council during the Republic era. He died on an off-screen mission sometime shortly before the Clone Wars began. Evan Piel. Evan Piel was a Lannic Jedi Master who served on the High Council during the Republic era and the Clone Wars. Piel died on a mission after Separatists blew up an aerial platform he was on. Agen Kolar. Agen Kolar was a Zabrak Jedi Master who served on the High Council. He's another one of the Jedi that can be seen being killed by Palpatine when they try to arrest him. Stass Alley. Staff Alley was a Thalothian Jedi Master and cousin of fellow Jedi Master Adi Gallia. She was one of the many Jedi that were killed in Order 66 when her clones shot her down on speeder bikes. Bastila Shan. Bastila Shan was a Jedi Master who fought in the Jedi Civil War during the fall of the Old Republic. At some point, she fell in love with Darth Raven, and after the Battle of Rakata Prime, they married and had a kid. Eventually, Raven left, and she never saw him again, leaving her to spend the rest of her life raising their son alone. Salacious B. Crumb. Salacious B. Crumb was a Kowakian monkey lizard who worked as the jester for Jabba the Hutt. He did a pretty good job keeping Jabba entertained until his death during the rescue of carbonited Han Solo. Max Rebo. Max Rebo was an Ortolian jizz-whaler musician. His band mainly played for criminals, as he can be seen playing for Jabba the Hutt during the Imperial era and a criminal cantina on Tatooine during the New Republic era. It's unclear whether or not he survived the bombing of said cantina, but unlike Salacious B. Crumb, he did survive Jabba's barge exploding, so who knows. Captain Panaka. Captain Panaka was a security forces captain of Naboo and guarded Queen Padme Amidala when the Trade Federation invaded Naboo. After the Empire rose to power, he remained loyal to Palpatine and was made Moff for his home sector, though sometime later he would be assassinated by rebel fighter Saw Gerrera. Finis Valorum. Finis Valorum was the Supreme Chancellor of the Republic before Palpatine. Due to the Trade Federation's invasion of Naboo, Queen Padme Amidala called for a vote of no confidence. This, of course, led to Palpatine becoming Chancellor, and Valorum's fate is left a mystery. Watto. I'm gonna be honest, I have no idea why Watto's all the way down here, but whatever. Watto was a Toydarian junk dealer and human trafficker on Tatooine who used to own Shmi and Anakin Skywalker. Watto lost Anakin in a bet with Qui-Gon Jinn and eventually sold Shmi. In canon, he's probably doing fine, but in Legends, it's implied that Vader tortured and killed him. Cool. IG-88. IG-88B, or just IG-88, is a rogue IG series assassin droid who worked as a bounty hunter. He was one of the many bounty hunters hired by Vader to locate Han Solo. Bendu. Bendu was a Force-sensitive entity who lived on the planet Atalon. He claimed to represent the center of the Force, between the light and the dark side. After Grand Admiral Thrawn invaded Atalon, Bendu disappeared, never to be seen again. Ochi. Ochi was an assassin for the Sith Order who did jobs for the criminal underworld and Darth Sidious himself. He had a knife that somehow knew where the pieces of the second Death Star would land. He would end up dying after falling in a sinkhole on Pisana. Hondo Onaka. Hondo Onaka is a Wiike pirate and outlaw who's been active since the Clone Wars. After the Clone Wars ended, his gang was broken up and he mainly acted as a small-time smuggler. Darth Nihilus. Darth Nihilus was a Dark Lord of the Sith who ruled in the aftermath of the Jedi Civil War. During his reign, he trained Visas Mar as an apprentice. Eventually, he was killed by Mitra Surik on his own ship. Exar Kun. Exar Kun was a Jedi Knight turned Dark Lord of the Sith and responsible for waging war against the Galactic Republic and Jedi Order, thus starting the old Sith Wars. He trained a ton of apprentices, though during a ritual to separate his spirit from his body, he accidentally trapped his soul on Yavin 4. Thousands of years later, Luke Skywalker and his new Jedi apprentices banished his spirit from the planet. Yaddle. Yaddle was a Jedi Master of the High Council and of the same species as Master Yoda. Shortly after the Battle of Naboo, she had suspicions about Count Dooku, and after investigating him for some time, Dooku was eventually told by Palpatine to kill her, which he did. Geode. Geode was a starship navigator and a member of the species known as the Vintin. The Vintin are basically just sentient rock people. He was responsible for transporting Jedi to the space station known as Starlight Beacon during the Great Hyperspace Disaster. Darth Krayt. Darth Krayt, also known as the Dragon of the Sith, was a former Jedi Master and Sith Lord. He was a Jedi General during the Clone Wars and friend of Anakin Skywalker. He was one of the few to survive Order 66 and escape to his homeworld of Tatooine for sanctuary. However, after a conversation with Obi-Wan resulted in him learning the true identity of Darth Vader, he left Tatooine and started to learn the ways of the dark side. He would end up dying over 100 years after the Empire fell when, after failing to convert Luke Skywalker's great-great-great-grandson, Cade Skywalker, to the dark side, he was killed by him. Pablo Jill. Pablo Jill was an Ungry Jedi Knight who participated in the First Battle of Geonosis. His fate in canon is unknown, however in Legends he was killed in a fight with General Grievous. Jaden Kor. Jaden Kor was the apprentice of Kyle Katarn and Jedi at Luke Skywalker's Jedi Academy. At some point, his consciousness was transferred into a clone body. He had no memory of this transfer and returned to Luke's Jedi Academy, so I guess it was all for nothing. Ponda Baba. Ponda Baba was the Aquilish thug who harassed Luke Skywalker in the cantina in A New Hope. After Obi-Wan cut off his arm, his friend Dr. Evazan tried to surgically attach a new one, but the procedure was a failure and it almost killed him. He's fine now, though. Trauma. Trauma was an advanced Recon Force scout trooper and clone commander who served during the Clone Wars. While defending the Temple of Edith from Separatist forces, he engaged in a one-on-one battle with Count Dooku's new apprentice, Savage Opress. He was promptly defeated and killed. Biggs Darklighter. Biggs Darklighter was a rebel pilot and member of Red Squadron who participated in the assault on the first Death Star alongside Luke Skywalker. He was unfortunately killed by Darth Vader during the attack. Free Ta. Free Ta was a Twi'lek politician who served at the Galactic Senate as senator for the planet Ryloth. He was known to be greedy and was extremely unpopular, but was loyal to the Republic during the Clone Wars, and eventually acted as a puppet for the Empire during the Imperial era. His fate post-Empire is unknown. Darth Cadus. Darth Cadus, originally known as Jason Solo, was the son of Leia and Han Solo. Similar to Anakin Skywalker, Jason used to be a Jedi Knight before ultimately falling to the dark side. His descent into the dark side lasted for about a year until his twin sister Jaina Solo fought and killed him. Darth Desolus. Darth Desilus was a Palwan former Jedi Master turned Sith Lord. After being kicked out of the Jedi Order for studying the dark side, he swore revenge on them and assembled a small army. Him and his men killed around 2,000 Jedi before ultimately being killed when a large Jedi fleet trapped them on the planet Yagna Minor. Cade Skywalker. Cade Skywalker was a bounty hunter, smuggler, and pirate who used to be a Jedi Padawan who trained under Master Wolf Sazen. Cade is presumably the great-great-great-grandson of Luke Skywalker. We don't know the exact lineage. Cade stopped being a Jedi after witnessing his father being killed by Darth Nihil of the One Sith. But as stated previously, Cade would be the one to defeat and kill Darth Krayt. In the aftermath of that battle, Cade would decide to become a Jedi again. Ben Skywalker. Ben Skywalker is the son of Luke and Mara Jade Skywalker. He was a Jedi Knight and was very loyal to his father, accompanying him through many battles against many Sith. He was last seen helping Luke destroy the previously talked about Abeloth. Visas Mar. Visas Mar was a Sith apprentice who lived during the Jedi Civil War. She was the apprentice of Darth Nihilus, however after a fight with Mitra Surik, the Jedi Exile, she was turned to the light side and became her apprentice. Darth Sion. Darth Sion, also known as the Lord of Pain, was a Sith Lord who lived during the Old Sith Wars. He fought as a Sith Marauder in the Great Sith War until he eventually died. However, because of the amount of pain and hatred he still had, he was able to rise from the dead, essentially achieving immortality. However, that came at the cost of his body constantly decomposing. Nevertheless, this caused him to survive until the end of the war. Afterwards, he would ally himself with Darth Trya and Darth Nihilus. Eventually, he would end up fighting the Jedi exile Mitra Surik, where, after repeatedly dying and coming back to life, would realize the price he had paid for his immortality and decide to give up and allow himself to die peacefully. Anya Solo. Anya Solo is the descendant of Han and Leia Solo. She was a simple junk dealer before being caught up in a few adventures, including ones having to do with the One Sith. Despite all of that, she continues to roam the galaxy with her friends. Cole Skywalker. Cole Skywalker was a Jedi Master and distant descendant of Luke Skywalker. When the Fell Empire, alongside the One Sith, took over, Cole refused to submit to them. This ultimately resulted in his death at the hands of a horde of Sith warriors. Corran Horn. Corran Horn was a Corellian pilot and later Jedi Master. After the fall of the Empire, Horn learned of his Force sensitivity and trained at Luke Skywalker's Jedi Academy, eventually rising to the rank of Master. Ulic Keldroma. Ulic Keldroma was a Jedi Knight of the Old Republic, a warlord, and eventual Sith Lord. Though, at the end of the Great Sith War, Keldroma would eventually renounce the dark side after being defeated by the Jedi. He would go into self-exile before being killed by a random pilot. Kip Duron. Kip Duron was a Jedi Master at Luke Skywalker's New Jedi Order. Imprisoned at a young age by the Galactic Empire, his hatred for said empire was sensed by Sith Lord Exar Kun, who kept close tabs on him when Duron was freed from his captivity by Han Solo. Solo would bring Kip to Luke's Jedi Academy. That's when Exar Kun began to influence Kip's judgment to the point where Kip accidentally killed his own brother. But after Skywalker and his apprentices defeated and banished Kun's spirit from Yavin 4, Kip returned to the light side and eventually became one of the first Jedi Masters of the New Order. Mace Tawani. Mace Tawani was a teenage kid who lived during the Imperial era. After him and his family accidentally crash-landed on Endor, his parents went missing, and he asked a nearby tribe of Ewoks to find them, which of course they did. The family and the Ewoks celebrated the successful rescue, however shortly after, Mace would be killed in an explosion when raiders attacked the Ewok village. Catarine Tawani. On a related note, the mother of Mace Tawani was Catarine Tawani. I pretty much summed up her story when I talked about Mace, but she also died when the raiders attacked the Ewok village. Joris Kaboth. Joris Kaboth, with two U's, is a dark Jedi and clone of Jedi Master Joris Kaboth, with one U. He was created by Palpatine and would end up being killed by Luke's wife, Mara Jade. Sana Staros. Sana Staros was a pilot who lived during the Galactic Civil War and a student at the University of Barleth. She worked as a smuggler for the Rebellion and at one point weirdly claimed that she was married to Han Solo, though that obviously never happened. Kolmon Kajak. Kolmon Kajak was an angry Jedi Master on the High Council who, like his fellow Jedi, participated heavily during the Clone Wars. He was one of the few Jedis to survive Order 66, but he would be killed a decade later by an Inquisitor, Sislin Mir. Sislin Mir was a Jedi Master and the one responsible for teaching Mace Windu the ways of the Force. That's pretty much it. Not much is known about her. Mitra Surik. Mitra Surik, also known as the Jedi Exile, was a Jedi Master who lived thousands of years before the events of the movies. She played a vital role in the Mandalorian Wars, ultimately helping the Jedi win. However, due to some controversial things she did during the final battle of that war, she was exiled from the Jedi Order. I've already mentioned a bunch of things she did in the previous parts of the Berg, but she would ultimately be killed when she teamed up with Sith Lord Scourge. Scourge would betray Surik and stab her in the back, killing her. Atriss. Atriss was a Jedi historian and later Jedi Master during the Mandalorian Wars and Jedi Civil War. She was a devout follower of the Jedi Code and hated the idea of going to war. At one point, while trying to understand the Sith and their beliefs, she would slowly turn to the dark side. But that would be short-lived, however, as the Jedi Exile would convince her to come back to the light. Satel Shan. Satail Shan was the Jedi Grandmaster during the Cold War and Galactic War between the Republic and the Sith Empire. Though after the Eternal Empire conquered both the Republic and Sith Empire, she would become depressed and exile herself from the Jedi Order forever. Jolie Bindo. Jolie Bindo was a Jedi Master who served on the Jedi Order during the Great Sith War. Near the end of it, he became friends with Darth Raven when they teamed up to defeat Darth Malak. Jodo Cast. Jodo Cast was a bounty hunter and member of the Rebel Alliance Special Ops. Like Boba Fett, he wore Mandalorian armor despite not being a Mandalorian himself. Actually, that was the point. He even painted his armor to look like Boba Fett after he fell in the Sarlacc pit. He pretended to be him to gain notoriety and raise his prices. Though it eventually caught up to him when the real Boba Fett lured him into a trap which inevitably killed him. Lord Kallig. Alosius Kallig was a Sith Lord of the Old Sith Empire. Originally born into a wealthy family, he left it all behind to train for the Sith Empire. Due to his impressive skill with a lightsaber, he fought alongside Sith Lord Tulak Horde, though Horde would eventually turn on Kallig and kill him. Darth Barriss. Darth Barriss was a Dark Lord of the Sith during the Great Galactic War. Over his lifetime, he trained multiple apprentices and, of course, one of them would be the cause of his death. Darth Thanaton. Darth Thanaton was an Inquisitor and Dark Lord of the Sith Empire during the Great Galactic War. He used to be a slave until he was discovered and trained by Sith Lord Kalifo. He would eventually engage in an ancient Sith honor battle with Sith Lord Kallig, where Thanaton would ultimately lose and was forced to flee in shame. But Kallig followed him and beat him again. And because of Thanaton's many failures, the disappointed Dark Lords of the Sith Council snapped his neck. Darth Malgus. Darth Malgus was a Sith Lord of the Sith Empire during the Great Galactic War. During a battle on Alderaan, he was heavily wounded and was permanently forced to wear a respirator. He was last seen being imprisoned, albeit still alive. His current fate is unknown. Dak Ralter. Dak Ralter was a Rebel pilot and member of Rogue Squadron during the Galactic Civil War. During the Battle of Hoth, he would fly with Luke Skywalker, who he was a big fan of. Unfortunately, he would die pretty quickly after their snowspeeder was shot down. Patissa. Patissa is the Rancor that can be seen in Return of the Jedi. He was the pet of Mala Keeley and lived in Jabba's basement for years. But, as I'm sure you all know, he was ultimately killed by Luke Skywalker when he fell into his lair. Jaster Mereel. Jaster Mereel was a bounty hunter and the mentor of Jango Fett. Born on Concord Dawn, Jaster would leave and join the Mandalorians. During his time with them, he would quickly build up a reputation as a good soldier. But Jaster believed that Mandalorians should be honorable mercenaries and tried to reform the whole group as a more peaceful organization. Of course, Mandalorians such as the Death Watch disagreed with him and a civil war broke out. During this war, he would save a farm boy now known as Jango Fett. He would raise him as a son until he was ultimately killed during the Battle of Korda 6. Sebulba. Sebulba was an expert pod racer and the rival of Anakin Skywalker. They both competed in the Bunta Eve Classic, where Anakin, of course, won. Though, something I found funny is that in Legends, Sebulba actually contacted Anakin 8 years later after the original race and organized a Rocky III-style rematch where the winner is unknown. Ben Quadanaros. Ben Quadanaros was another pod racer who competed in the Bunta Eve Classic of 32. Like Anakin, his pod racer would stall, though unlike Anakin, he wasn't able to get it to work. I guess that makes him lucky though, because he probably would have died during that race. Captain Fordo. Alpha 77, aka Arc 77, aka Captain Fordo, was an Alpha Class Advanced Recon Clone Commando Captain. He was part of a task force led by Obi-Wan Kenobi, and together they were able to win the Battle of Munila Nest. Directly after the battle, Fordo and his men survived an encounter with General Grievous, though most people probably know him from this awesome scene. Anakin Solo. Anakin Solo is the third child of Han and Leia. Anakin was often afraid of turning to the dark side, and can you blame him? He's named after one of the most notorious Sith Lords out there. He never did turn, though, and would end up dying in the war against the Yuuzhan Vong. Jaina Solo. Jaina Solo was the daughter of Han and Leia and the twin sister of Jason Solo. She was also a Jedi Master of the new Jedi High Council. She aided Luke Skywalker in his fight against Abeloth, and as a result, Luke granted her the title of Master. Anya Kuro. Anya Kuro was a respected Jedi Master during the Clone Wars. She was also the Master of Aurra Sing. When Sing left and made a name for killing Jedi, Anya exiled herself until she was killed shortly after Order 66 by Darth Vader. Hey, cool, we made it here. This is the first tier where I don't recognize a single character. Nice. Let's get into it. Gary the Stormtrooper. Gary the Stormtrooper is a Robot Chicken original character. He is 29 and lives with his wife and daughter on the Death Star. Shaggy. Shaggy was a Jedi Knight during the Clone Wars and clearly resembles Shaggy Rogers from Scooby-Doo. He was unfortunately killed by General Grievous, although he probably left this universe on purpose due to the fact that he could have solved all of Star Wars' problems with just 2% of his power. Freedon Nadd. Freedon Nadd was an Old Republic Jedi and eventual Dark Lord of the Sith. He would live a long life before dying to natural causes, though his spirit prevailed. His own apprentice, however, would be the one to banish and defeat his spirit for good. Tra-Saw. Tra-Saw was a Neti Jedi Master who served during the Republic era. She participated in the Clone Wars and was eventually killed when a crash-landing starfighter caused an explosion. Luke. Luke Skywalker with two U's is a clone of Jedi Master Luke Skywalker with one U. He was created by Captain Gilad Pallion using the cut-off hand Luke lost in Cloud City. Luke trained under the clone I mentioned earlier, Master Jor-Ros Kaboth. After Jor-Ros failed to convert 1U Luke and his wife to the dark side, he sent 2U Luke to kill them. However, he would fail in this mission, as Mara Jade would end up killing him. Baltar Swan. Baltar Swan was a Jedi Knight who trained under Master Plo Koon. In Legends, she was one of the few to survive Order 66, and alongside some other survivors, set up a trap for Darth Vader. The Jedi survivors actually managed to overwhelm and beat Vader, however, after getting into an argument with fellow Jedi Kofi Arana over whether or not they should kill him, Arana would unexpectedly stab and kill Swan. Davin Felth. Davin Felth is literally just this guy.
Look, sir, droid.
Dash Rendar. Dash Rendar was a smuggler and pilot who was active during the Imperial era. Despite helping the Rebellion a few times, even aiding in the acquisition of the second Death Star plans, he never officially joined them. Ellen Sleazebagano. Again, this guy can be summed up in one clip.
You wanna buy some death sticks?
You don't want to sell me death sticks.
I don't want to sell you death sticks.
You want to go home and rethink your life?
I want to go home and rethink my life.
Darth Krall. Darth Krall was a former member of the Jedi Order and a powerful Sith Lord. Other than the fact that he participated in the Battle of Wasted Years, not much is known about him. Darth Cognis. Darth Cognis, aka the Huntress, was an assassin turned Dark Lord of the Sith. She trained under Darth Bane and eventually got an apprentice of her own, and because of the Rule of Two, she was most likely killed by him at some point. Boshek. Boshek is the guy who can be seen leading Obi-Wan to Han Solo in A New Hope. That's pretty much it for him in canon, but in Legends he actually stole the Kessel Run record from Han Solo shortly before that scene happened. Darth Vectivus. Darth Vectivus was a Sith Lord who lived centuries before the main movie events. Despite being an avid user of the dark side, he was very disciplined and never obsessed over power like every other Sith. He actually spent most of his life serving as a director of a mining colony and living with his friends and families till he died. Lumia. Lumia was a former agent of the Galactic Empire and Dark Lady of the Sith. She was born during the Imperial era and actually trained under Vader and Palpatine for a time. She mainly worked as an assassin for Palpatine, though. After the fall of the Empire, she began to hate Luke for killing her masters. She would eventually die to Luke Skywalker, but she would die happy knowing that she helped turn his nephew Jason Solo to the dark side. Natasi Dalla. Natasi Dalla was the first woman to achieve the rank of Admiral in the Imperial Navy. She was mentored under Grand Moff Tarkin, and the two eventually started a relationship. After the Empire fell, she wanted to get revenge for Tarkin's death and the Empire as a whole. She later became the Chief of State of the Galactic Federation of Free Alliances, where she expressed many anti-Jedi sentiments. However, a group of Jedi started a coup against her, which resulted in her surrender. Talon Card. Talon Card was a smuggler and information broker who was basically the head of the information underground market. He was mainly active during the Galactic Civil War, though tried his best to not pick sides. Darth Gravid. Darth Gravid was a Dark Lord of the Sith who, over time, slowly lost his mind. He was somehow convinced that the only way to preserve the order of the Sith Lords was to destroy the old Sith teachings. He destroyed a good amount before being killed by his apprentice, Darth Geen. His destruction of old Sith lore actually set the Sith organization back a few centuries. Pretty funny. Nuru Kungurama. Nuru Kungurama was a Chiss Jedi Padawan during the Republic era. He trained under Master Lanshu Ska, and when he died, trained under Master Ring Sol Ambase. It is unknown whether or not he survived Order 66. Deke Starkiller, Kane Starkiller, and Anakin Starkiller. The Starkiller family was a family who used to live on the planet Utapau. When the new Galactic Empire came to Utapau, Kane, the father, tried to flee with his sons. However, one of his sons, Deke, was killed during the escape. Kane then asked Luke Skywalker to take his other son in as a Padawan. Kane would later die sacrificing himself to help a group of heroes reach the Forbidden Systems. Theron Nett. Theron Nett was a rebel pilot during the Galactic Civil War and member of Red Squadron. He assisted Luke Skywalker during the assault on the first Death Star, but was shot down by one of Darth Vader's wingmate TIE fighters. Puck Nako. Puck Nako was another member of Red Squadron who helped Luke assault the first Death Star. Puck was shot down and killed by Darth Vader himself. Davish Krayl. Davish Pops Krayl was another rebel pilot shot down by Vader during the Death Star assault. However, unlike the previous guys, Krayl was a part of Gold Squadron. Dex Tyri. Another member of Gold Squadron, Dex Tyri, also took part in the Death Star assault. Again, this guy was killed by Darth Vader. John D. Brannan, Red Squadron, killed by TIE Fighter. John Vander, Gold Squadron, killed by Vader. Ramus Antilles. Ramus Antilles was a member of the Rebel Alliance and was the guy assigned to protect Princess Leia before he got choked to death by Vader. Garvin Dreis. Man, I thought we were done with these. Red Squadron, killed by Vader. Kit Valant and Zev Seneska. Both of these guys were actually a part of Rogue Squadron. They were co-pilots during the Battle of Hoth and died together when their airspeeder was shot down. Derek Cliven. Derek Cliven was another member of Rogue Squadron who died on Hoth. He actually sacrificed himself by intentionally crashing his speeder into an AT-AT. Lorth Nida. Lorth Nida was the captain of the Imperial Star Destroyer, Avenger. During the Battle of Hoth, Nida led the chase for Han Solo and the Millennium Falcon. After he lost Solo, Nida decided to take full responsibility and apologize to Darth Vader himself.
Apology accepted, Captain Nida.
Darth Millennial. Darth Millennial was a three-eyed mutant Sith Lord who lived over 1,000 years before the Battle of Yavin. He didn't like a lot of the rules of the Sith though, specifically the Rule of Two. He would end up leaving everything to settle on a swamp planet, kind of like Yoda. However, there he would start his own religion and called it the Dark Force, though he would eventually just die of old age. Zet Jukasa. Zet Jukasa was a Jedi Padawan during the Clone Wars. He was seen fighting clones during Order 66 before being overwhelmed and killed by them. Fun fact, he was played by George Lucas's son, Jet Lucas. John Antilles. John Antilles was a Jedi Master who lived during the Republic era. He was considered a legend among Jedi due to his many accomplishments and the fact that he wouldn't report back to the Jedi for months at a time. This actually caused people to think that he was dead a couple of times. But John would actually die during a confrontation with a bounty hunter known as Dirge, where said bounty hunter pushed him into a lava stream. Next tier, let's just get into it. Darth Tenebrius. Darth Tenebrius was a Dark Lord of the Sith and master of Darth Plagueis the Wise. He was a scientific mastermind and obsessed with the future. He actually has a pretty messed up fate. So, of course, his apprentice, Darth Plagueis, is the one who kills him, but in an attempt to save himself, Tenebrius actually got caught in a time loop where he has to relive his death for eternity. Nakata Del Gormo. Nakata Del Gormo was an ancient Hisalrian Jedi Master and the one who trained Master Yoda. Not much is known about him out of and in-universe, as most of that info was lost when the Empire destroyed the Jedi Archives. Ikrit. Ikrit was a Jedi Master trained by Master Yoda. Sometime before the Clone Wars, he discovered a temple on Yavin 4 that trapped the souls of a ton of children. After failing to save them, he decided to just stay on Yavin 4 until someone who could save them came along. Because of this, he missed the Clone Wars, Order 66, and the entire Imperial era. Eventually, a young Anakin Solo came along and was able to finally free the souls of the children. Because of this, he decided to accompany him on his adventures until the Yuuzhan Vong War, where Ikrit sacrificed himself to save Anakin. Leppy. I'm not really sure why this is on here. Leppy isn't a character, it's a species of rabbit-looking people. So instead I'll just talk about the only Leppy with a name, Jackson. Jackson T. Tumparaki is a Leppy smuggler from Coachell Prime. He was mainly active during the Imperial era, and as far as we know, he's still smuggling to this day. Mount of Sorrow. Mount Sorrow is a sentient mountain on the forest moon of Endor. It had the power to blow people off the summit, or cry tears of healing. It was an obscure figure in Ewok lore, only known to the shaman and witch doctors. It was always in a constant state of depression, though it would grant tears of healing to anyone it deemed worthy. Ken. Ken, no last name given, is the son of a guy named Triclops and a Jedi princess named Kendallina. Triclops was supposedly the unwanted son of Palpatine, making Ken the grandson of Palpatine. He grew up in the Lost City of the Jedi on Yavin 4 and was raised by a bunch of caretaker droids. He never did become a Jedi though, despite being related to one of the most powerful Force users. He eventually met Luke Skywalker at one point and decided to join the Rebellion and eventually the New Republic. Nissa. Nissa was an Ewok and the daughter of Chirpa, the chief of the Council of Elders. She bravely fought during the Battle of Endor, and because of that and her strong leadership, she became the village's first female chief. Beldorian. Beldorian was a Hutt Jedi Knight who served in the Jedi Republic hundreds of years before the Imperial era. At one point, he was sent on a mission to Nam Carosis. There, he fell to the dark side and took over the planet. 400 years later, he would be killed in a lightsaber duel by Leia Organa. Uru. Uru was a Seleukian Jedi Master who lived thousands of years before the Battle of Yavin. His species breathed the gas that is deadly to most species, so he had to wear a life support chamber most of the time. Kinda like Plo Koon. When the Sith Empire attacked the Republic, he was overwhelmed by the Masasi warriors who destroyed his life support tank, killing him and everyone around him. Odan Ur. Odan Ur was a Drythos Jedi Master who used to be the apprentice of Uru before he died. Odin would die in the lead up to the Great Sith War when he was killed by a young Exar-Kun, Thon. Thon was a Chukthai Jedi Master who was active during the events of the Great Sith War. He trained multiple apprentices over his lifetime and is one of the few Jedi to survive the Great Sith War. He most likely ended up dying of natural causes. Malay-Di was a politician who served in the Senate during the Clone Wars. He was notably suspicious of Palpatine, but he never really did anything about it. Darth Nihil. Darth Nihil was a Nagai Sith Lord who served in Darth Krayt's Galactic Empire during the Sith Imperial War. He used to be a warlord before being personally recruited into the One Sith by Darth Krayt himself. After the defeat of the One Sith, he along with the rest of the surviving members went into hiding. Darth Noctis. Darth Noctis was an ancient Sith Lord who apparently had the ability to create a permanent Sith Empire. Instead, she decided to focus her entire career on discovering the secrets of immortality. She was unsuccessful, of course, but one thing that's cool about her is she has a weird curved lightsaber. Darth Kaldoth. Darth Kaldoth was an ancient Duros Sith Lord. He had an apprentice at one point, but ended up killing him in a Sith ritual. He's mostly known for coming into conflict with the Dathomirian Night Sisters when he trapped a member of their coven's consciousness in his own mind. Darth Warlock. There's actually three Sith Lords who went by the name Darth Warlock. All of them were Darth Krayt's chief lieutenants and replaced each other when one of them died. There was supposed to be a Darth Warlock the fourth, but that never happened. Teta. Teta was the Empress of the Koros system and was a key military commander in the Great Hyperspace War. She was famous for crippling Sith Lord Nagasato's entire fleet, thus ending the war. She ended up ruling for 175 years in total and had the entire system renamed after her. Jasper. Jasper is a Sakian bounty hunter who can be seen sitting at a table in the Mos Eisley Cantina in A New Hope. He was pretty active during both the Republic and Imperial era and was regularly hired by Jabba the Hutt. Cardu Saimalak. Cardu Saimalak is a Devaran former army captain and the devil-looking guy at the cantina in A New Hope. He was a pretty cruel army captain and committed a lot of war crimes and racked up one of the highest bounties in the galaxy. Riker Rajurd. Riker Rajurd was another cantina guy who can be seen in A New Hope. He often trained and taught people about smuggling and piloting. He was an expert gunrunner and also happened to speak Jawaese. Kitik Kid Kak. Another cantina patron, Kitik Kid Kak, was part of the praying mantis-looking species Yamri. Darovit. Darovit, also known as Tomcat, was a Jedi Padawan and later Sith, who happened to be the cousin of Darth Xana. He would end up being caught up in a plot involving Darth Bane where he would be driven mad with illusions, causing him to unwillingly attack the Jedi, where he was killed almost instantly. Hetan. Hetan was an ancient Force user who, at first, had no allegiances to either the Jedi or the Sith, though after witnessing Darth Xana's control over the dark side, he decided to become her apprentice. But Xana would only accept him under one condition, he would help her defeat her master Darth Bane. However, this would only result in his own death. Ellis Hellrot. Ellis Hellrot is another New Hope Cantina member. He was part of the species known as the Given and witnessed Han shooting Greedo. Lobaka. Lobaka was a Wookiee Jedi Knight during the Yuuzhan Vong War and the nephew of Chewbacca. He studied at Luke Skywalker's Jedi Academy and had a bronze lightsaber. Mamau Nadon. Mamau Nadon, also known as Hammerhead, was an Ithorian New Hope Cantina patron. He was exiled from his home when he revealed the agricultural secrets of his planet to the Empire. Kelleron Beck. Kelleron Beck was a Jedi Master in the Jedi Order who orchestrated the game show known as the Jedi Temple Challenge. I cannot believe this is canon. Pulvin Cut. Pulvin Cut was a Jedi Master who lived roughly 200 years before the Clone Wars. He also happened to train Master Yaddle. His family was murdered by a warmonger named Tulok. Years later, while on a mission with Yaddle, he came into contact with Tulok. Unable to control himself, he fell to the dark side before being overwhelmed by Tulok's forces and was killed. Ajunta Pall. Ajunta Pall was a Jedi Master and eventual leader of the Dark Jedi that were exiled from the Republic following the Hundred Year Darkness. He is considered the first Sith Lord. He eventually died of natural causes, but his spirit prevailed until his soul was redeemed by Jedi Knight Raven during the Jedi Civil War. Zendor. Zendor was a general of the Legions of Letao, a group of dark side users. He disagreed with the teachings of the Jedi and ended up getting in a war with them, which ultimately led to his death. Wolf Yularen. Wolf Yularen was a Coruscant bureaucrat and Imperial military officer. He used to serve in the Republic Navy during the Clone Wars, often working with Anakin Skywalker and Ahsoka Tano. He would end up being destroyed along with the Death Star when it blew up. Antonio Motti. Conan Antonio Motti was an Imperial Navy admiral and another victim of Luke Skywalker's bombing of the first Death Star. He's also the guy known for being choked by Darth Vader in A New Hope. Jude Edavan. Jude Edavan was an officer in the Imperial Navy. She actually discovered the first Death Star's exhaust port weakness minutes before it blew up. Unfortunately for her, she was on the station when it blew. Velkin Tezzeri. Velkin Tezzeri was a former Imperial technician and later henchman for Jabba the Hutt. He's the first guy to fall into the Sarlacc pit in Return of the Jedi. Vidane. Vidane was a, not saying that, slave owned by Jabba the Hutt and another victim of the Sarlacc in return. Brock Starcher. Brock Starcher was another guard for Jabba in return. Of course, he also literally fell victim to the Sarlacc. Poat Snicken. Poat Snicken was an arms dealer, pilot, and, you guessed it, Jabba guard. You want to take a wild guess as to how he died? I'll give you a hint. Rhymes with Barlack. Kithaba. Jabba slave. Sarlacc. Visan. I'm gonna be honest here, I couldn't find anything about a Visan. It's probably a typo, but if I had to guess, it's probably another Sarlacc victim. Klaatu. Klaatu was a gambler and skiff repairman for Jabba the Hutt. He was struck down by Luke Skywalker, but didn't die until the entire barge exploded. Salt Mare. Salt Mare was an informant who worked for Jabba the Hutt. He was on Jabba's barge when everything went wrong, but ultimately survived the event. He ended up stealing a bunch of Jabba's financial secrets in the aftermath. Eye of Webbish Bog. The Eye of Webbish Bog was a force-sensitive spider-like creature who lived on Mustafar. It had encounters with both Darth Vader and Kylo Ren, both times giving them the location of a Sith Wayfinder to the planet Exegol. Wow, second to last tier. Technically, if you look at the picture, this isn't even a part of the iceberg anymore, but let's just get right into it. Jedi Bob. Bob was an unnamed Jedi Knight who was part of the Republic gunship LEGO set and was given his name by fans. He was officially given his name in the LEGO Star Wars Visual Dictionary, the book that I actually had as a kid. Cool. Soon Bates. Soon Bates was a Jedi Master who served during the Republic era. He was killed by General Grievous when he crushed his skull. Brutal. Waru. Waru was a transdimensional being from a parallel universe. His species was unknown to any New Republic databases and had the ability to heal people. Waru was somehow unwillingly teleported from his home. Looking for a way to get back, he met a guy named Hethrir. Hethrir agreed to find a way to send him back home if Waru helped him achieve mastery of the Force. So in the meantime, Waru just kinda sat around and healed anyone who asked him. Not a bad guy if you ask me. Eventually the Skywalker family got involved and it all ended with Waru and Hethrir having a falling out. It's unknown what happened to Waru. Some say he managed to teleport back to his dimension, others say he died. Who knows? Jenny. Jenny was another New Hope Cantina patron who can be seen in the background talking to a Rodian. She also had a deleted scene where she can be seen kissing Han Solo. Nee Elevar. Nee Elevar was a senator of the Galactic Republic during the Clone Wars. She was one of the many politicians who were skeptical of Palpatine. In Legends, she was arrested and executed during Order 66. Fang Zar. Fang Zar was a Republic-era politician who was very publicly against Palpatine. He would end up being killed by Darth Vader when he threw his lightsaber at him. Yuster. Tan Yuster was a Padawan and among the many Jedi who were present at the Battle of Geonosis that started the Clone Wars. He was killed by an overwhelming amount of super battle droids. Edema. Similar to Yuster, Lumos Edema was a Jedi Padawan who fell during the Battle of Geonosis. Labuda. Again, Labuda was another Jedi Geonosis victim. Raeli. Raeli was a Jedi Master during the Clone Wars who actually survived the Geonosis battle and retired shortly after. His retirement wouldn't last forever though, as he would be beheaded by a fallen Jedi called Malus. Jang. So, there are a bunch of people in Star Wars named Jang, but I'm gonna have to assume they mean Sarissa Jang, another Jedi Knight who participated in the Battle of Geonosis. She survived the fight, and her fate is unknown. Makota. Makota was a Jedi Knight and another Geonosis victim. Jossal. Seth Jet Jossal was another Jedi Knight present at the Battle of Geonosis. This guy gave Obi-Wan Kenobi a lightsaber after he was freed. Tasu. Nikanas Tasu was another Geonosis Jedi. This guy was the one to give Anakin a lightsaber. Both him and Jossal survived, if you were wondering. Dans Boren. Dans Boren was a bounty hunter who was present at the cantina in A New Hope. He was actually trying to claim the bounty over Han Solo's head, but after seeing Han chew Greedo, I guess he changed his mind. Darth Tigran. Darth Tigran was a Zabrak Sith Lord who was active during Darth Krayt's reign over the Galactic Empire. She was created for the video game Battle of the Sith Lords, which was ultimately cancelled. Tor Valum. Tor Valum was supposed to be the main antagonist of Disney's original Episode 9, Duel of the Fates, before it was cancelled and became Rise of Skywalker. He would have been a Dark Lord of the Sith and the master of Darth Plagueis the Wise. Kylo Ren would have sought him out so he can learn and master the dark side of the Force from him. Ren and Valum would end up fighting each other, with Ren ultimately defeating him by draining his life force. Wyoslia. Wyoslia was a Vovrian terrestrial vehicle merchant. In a deleted scene in A New Hope, she bought Luke Skywalker's landspeeder for 2,000 credits. Lisub Surlan. Lisub Surlan was a Force-sensitive Kurash Cantina patron who was present in A New Hope. She was a child slave until High Inquisitor Antonis Tremaine discovered her and wanted to train her. She didn't though, and escaped to the cantina where she can be seen talking to a Latrillian. Trinta Duaba. Trinta Duaba was another cantina patron who witnessed Obi-Wan cut a guy's hand off. But this guy also appeared 30 years later and can be seen at Maz Kanata's castle shortly before the building was leveled by the First Order. He survived too. Good for him. Suilla Corey. Suilla Corey was a former slave and current pickpocket who was also present at the cantina. Het Nikik. Het Nikik was a Jawa and New Hope cantina patron, but this guy was a so-called free-thinking Jawa. He believed that Jawas were not powerless and needed to push themselves to become stronger to fight back against their enemies. Unluckily for him though, after getting into a heated confrontation with some stormtroopers, his blaster failed to shoot and he was shot dead by them. Artel Dark. Artel Dark was a Sith apprentice who worked for Count Dooku during the Clone Wars. He was in charge of leading Separatist forces on the planet Dagoo and enslaving its inhabitants. His story was supposed to be told in the novel Escape from Dagoo, but it was cancelled. He still exists in Legends canon, however, since these events were referenced in other media. Merc Sunlet. Merc Sunlet was a thief from the planet Tirak Munda. He was yet another New Hope cantina patron. Dice Ebigon. Dice Ebigon was a Lamproid cantina patron and member of the Rebel Alliance. Apparently, she was Force-sensitive and had the ability to shift through time. She participated in the Battle of Hoth, but was killed by some falling debris. Luckily for her, though, she became a Force ghost. Deb Noli. Deb Noli was another cantina patron. He was a marksman who hated the Empire for impounding his ship. Lak Sivrak. Lak Sivrak was a werewolf-looking Shestavin and New Hope cantina extra. He used to be a scout for the Empire, though later joined the Rebellion and piloted an X-Wing during the Battle of Endor. Atha Prime. Atha Prime was an egotistical genetics master and the one who started the Clone Wars. By the way, this guy was created by the toy manufacturer Kenner Products before the prequels existed. Atha Prime was one of the few original characters they designed but never actually made. They wanted to make him canon, but Lucasfilm ultimately said no. Omo Bori. Omo Bori was a Wul Kabashite Jedi Master of the High Council who died a couple decades before the Clone Wars. Not much is known about this guy, there's not even any official visual representation of him, but we do know that his apprentice was Sais Tin. Fodisinbeed Anadu. Fodisinbeed Anadu, or simply known as Fod and Beed, were the pod race announcers seen in The Phantom Menace. Fod would speak in Basic, while Beed would speak in Huttese. Satoris Ramda. Satoris Ramda was a general of the Galactic Empire. He was the commander of the Scarif garrison during the Battle of Scarif. Ramda would die when Grand Moff Tarkin ordered the Death Star be fired on Scarif. Crichton Vallis. Crichton Vallis was an Imperial lieutenant who was also present on Scarif before its destruction. Of course, he also did not survive. Lapira. Lapira was a rebel pilot and member of Gold Squadron. He partook in the assault on the first Death Star and was shot down off-screen. Kessen Omis. Kessen Omis was a rebel pilot who joined a year after the Battle of Yavin. He fought in the Battle of Hoth and was wounded, but he ultimately survived. Videz Oneth. Videz Oneth was a member of the Sarish Defense Force and can only be seen in a deleted scene of Revenge of the Sith attending Padme's funeral. Tripto Bubal. Tripto Bubal was a rich patron of the Canto Bight Casino. He made his fortune thanks to his family's vast farming colonies of space fungi. Jek 14. Jek 14 is a character who appears in LEGO Star Wars The Yoda Chronicles. He's a Force-sensitive Sith clone created by Count Dooku. Yoda once gave him the chance to join the light side, but Jek decided to be neutral. During the Imperial era, he aided Luke Skywalker in the Rebellion before retiring and visiting Yoda on Dagobah one last time. GG. GG is one of Jar Jar Binks' three children seen in LEGO Star Wars The Yoda Chronicles. There's not much to say about him other than he once covered Darth Vader's armor in crayon. Luke. Luke Skywalker with three U's, not to be confused with Luke Skywalker with two U's or Luke Skywalker with one U, is another clone of 1U Luke created by Grand Admiral Thrawn. 3U Luke replaced 2U Luke after he died. Unfortunately, this guy is completely non-canon even in Legends, but at one point he travels back in time to the Clone Wars, so that's cool. Ashiel Scamini. Ashiel Scamini was the mother of future dead Padawan Zet Jakasa. She was murdered by Black Sun operatives 7 years after the birth of Zet. It was covered up, but Zet used the Force to solve the mystery and have the murderers arrested. Well guys, we made it. I'm gonna be honest here, this video is taking a lot longer to make than I originally expected. But here we are, the final tier of the iceberg. Let's not waste any time. Selig Kenjin. Selig Kenjin was a Jedi Knight and member of the Jedi Order during the Republic era. He was present during the Battle of Geonosis, but you can't see him. He was created by Hasbro and got all of his lore from there. He did survive though, so good for him. Rango Tell. Rango Tell was a bounty hunter and an extra in The Phantom Menace. He was apparently very dumb and believed that he was wearing Mandalorian armor. Calling him a bounty hunter is pretty generous though, since on his very first bounty mission, he was killed by the guy he was supposed to take in. Rum Slegg. Rum Slegg is another Phantom Menace extra who can be seen on Tatooine. He is apparently a Sebulba fan as he can be seen cheering him on during the Boonta Eve classic. The Sitter. The Sitter was a guy who lived on Jakku and all he would do all day was sit atop a pillar. His only appearance is in the kids' book, Star Wars Forces of Destiny, The Rey Chronicles. Sar Agorn. Sar Agorn was a Jedi Master who served in the Jedi Order during the early years of the Republic. Not much is known about him other than he kept a personal holocron on him, and he had an apprentice, that of Cope Shykril, Esu Astorni. Esu Astorni was a Zuul senator in the Galactic Senate during the Republic era. She can be seen attending Padme Amidala's funeral. Obi-Wan Impersonator. The Obi-Wan Impersonator was an Imperial actor who underwent surgery to look like Obi-Wan under orders from Darth Vader. His mission was to earn the trust of Luke Skywalker in the Rebellion. It seemed to work at first, but the Impersonator started to feel bad because he learned that Obi-Wan is a war hero and he was just a mere imposter. He would end up betraying Vader, and that went as well as you think it would. Before he died, however, he would end up telling Luke the truth. Akiel. Akiel is a Jawa Jedi who only appears in the Living Force campaign of the Star Wars RPG. Apparently, he became a Jedi Knight after graduating from the Almus Jedi Academy. Emptajios Brand. Emptajios Brand was a Jedi Knight and one of the few to survive Order 66. He was also the Padawan of Master Yaddle. Shortly after Order 66, he would be discovered and hunted down by Darth Vader himself. Vader shot down his ship, leaving Brand severely injured. He would survive, though, and was forced to be fitted with a prosthetic body. After the Empire fell, he would join Luke Skywalker's new Jedi Order. He would help Luke defeat a resurrected Palpatine, where he would capture Palp's soul within his own body before having Han Solo kill him, thus ending both his and Palpatine's life at the same time. Bidlo Quirv. Bidlo Quirv was an employee who worked for Jabba the Hutt. At some point, he displeased the Hutt and was tossed into the Rancor pit to be eaten. He would kind of get his revenge, though, as years later, Luke Skywalker would use his skull to hit the door control button in the pit, killing the Rancor. Indiana Jones. Indiana Jones is a historian and archaeologist from Earth. One time, while exploring ruins in Mexico, he was abducted by aliens who took him to the planet Xantar. There, he met Luke Skywalker, who helped him get back to Earth. Don't worry, guys, this isn't canon in Disney or Legends. Xiao Tugok. Xiao Tugok was an information scout and preacher. He is the product of the Star Wars Galaxy magazine's Design an Alien competition. According to Leland Chi, the guy who maintained the Holocron Continuity Database, anything published by the Design an Alien competition is canon, thus Xiao Tugok is canon, in Legends. Vetria Scoth. Another creation from the Design an Alien competition, Vetria Scoth is a bounty hunter armed with a suit of armor and a blaster rifle. Bibaka. Bibaka is the fusion of Bib Fortuna and Chewbacca. He was featured in an advertisement for the Wii version of LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. He does have lore, though. Apparently, he, quote, would typically sneak around with a poison dagger before fiercely eating his lunch and advising his criminal friends. Che Lelando. Che Lelando was a character portrayed by the previously mentioned Leland Chi. He played him in a trailer for the Star Wars Millennium Falcon, a 3D owner's guide book. This was basically just a 22-page book showing the inner workings of the Millennium Falcon. Anxi Ranxi Lanxi. Anxi Ranxi Lanxi was an author, scholar, and inventor from the planet Yidi. His only mention is from the book Monsters and Aliens from George Lucas that featured the character designs and photos from multiple George Lucas products. He is unfortunately non-canon, but he looks cool. Harmony. Harmony was a waitress who worked at Dex's Diner on Coruscant shortly before the Battle of Yavin. She also happened to date Boba Fett at one point. Harmony was created for the now-canceled Star Wars Detours show. Energizer Bunny. I think it's best if I just show you the clip.
The Energizer battery, it keeps going and going.
Iguni was a Jedi Padawan who trained under Yoda during the Clone Wars. He only exists in the non-canonical Star Wars manga, Evil Eyes. Gianna was a Jedi Padawan who trained at the Jedi Academy on Coruscant during the Republic era. She was a non-canonical character created for Jeffrey Brown's Jedi Academy kids novels. Rowan Novichez. Rowan Novichez is another Padawan created for Jeffrey Brown's Jedi Academy novels. He was born on Tatooine, but after learning that he was Force-sensitive, joined the Jedi Academy. Hijinks ensues. Rorn. Rorn was another character created for the Design an Alien competition. He served as a Jedi Knight during the Republic era and was one of the few to survive Order 66. And like that, the iceberg is complete. It was pretty good, but I would add and remove some things. Like, if you're going to mention the Design an Alien competition, at least add the winner of that competition. Ubi's Thornback War Dragon is easily the coolest. Anyway, even though I had fun making this and learning about some obscure Star Wars characters I've never heard of before, I'm glad to finally be done with this. I think I need to take a break from Star Wars, at least for a little while. In the meantime, I hope you learned at least one thing from this incredibly long video. And remember to like it if you liked it, subscribe if you really liked it, and I'll see you next time.